Welcome into the Buzz Studio.
Thank you very much for having me.
Justin from Blue October.
It is I.
They have a show tonight at the Flynn Theater.
Yep.
Nice enough to take some time to drop by the Buzz Studio today, say hi. I see you brought a guitar. That doesn't happen.
I brought a guitar because I'm from the old days where you come and you support your record, your radio station by playing songs, getting people excited about their community, and the only thing that does that for bands is radio, and we were talking about that a second ago, so I appreciate you taking the 15 minutes to let me do that.
We appreciate you. Congratulations on spreading the truth around.
Thank you.
It's been out about a year now.
Yep.
Part one. Part two on the way, and you got part three coming.
Yeah.
October 2024?
I might just drop it right afterwards. That's the beauty of owning your own record label. You can do whatever you want, and you can meet whoever you want, go wherever you want, say whatever you want, and be whoever you want.
Did you go into this like, I'm going to do a triple album, or did you just have so much material? I'm guessing, this is just a guess.
Huh, what?
COVID lockdown.
Whoa! Ding, 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 ding! Now, I was going to say, like, you can either do, there's two kinds of people. People that went down a spiral in COVID, or people that went, you know what, I'm gonna hustle during COVID. I'm gonna write as much as I can and learn as much as I can, and I just chose that one. And we wrote, I think, close to 80 something ideas and finished about 40 of them and put them on two records. And then the third one's a remix record with some of my favorite remixers, doing some of our hits and hits, doing some of our songs that we love that got a lot of airplay. There you go. That's what I got. You know what I'm saying? And so we have two albums, Spinning the Truth Around. And I'm super grateful that I have a studio right outside of my house and hardworking people that work for Uptown Records. And you were mentioning Steph Hardy, and just she's an angel, and
that's awesome.
Works with us. And she's the reason I get to come here and play music for you.
And so you were working from home.
Yeah.
You know, just like a lot of us, we're working from home. You're doing your job from home.
Yeah, like today I went outside and walked down, I think, Church Street. And I was just like, this is what I do for a living. This is crazy.
You were working from home, but Billy Corgan was called. I know that you and Billy wrote some stuff for the new album. And the part two, does he have songs on that
as
well?
There's a song called Don't Say It Wasn't Love that I wrote with Billy Corgan. Is a song called Sobriety, Peace I'm Seeking, that I wrote with Billy Corgan.
And how's this happen? How does this work itself out?
I got a call from my manager and said, hey, Billy Corgan wants to write with you. And I said, I think those were my exact words. And then I said, Chicago? And he said, yeah, you're going to go to Chicago, and you're going to go to his house. And then I went, again, those words. Because I'm going to Billy Corgan's house.
Crazy.
Compound, I mean. Crazy. Mansion. Awesome. Looks like a drug dealer's house. It's just super dope, you know? But this is the best part. We write all day. We go through like 12 songs. He's quick. So I'll sit there and I'll go, Billy, I got this idea. And he'll be like, all right, hold on. And he'll just kind of melody over it, no words, and he'll go, you're good at the words, man, but that's the melody right there. And I'm like, okay. And he goes, okay, next one, what's your next one? So we just did one. He goes, yeah, you're good enough, you finish it later. Well, let's get through these. And I'm just like, oh, this is awesome. But the best part of it was, he goes, let's take a break. And I'm like, all right, what do you want to go, Starbucks or something? And he goes, no, I got this old car. Let's go drive around the neighborhood. I'm like, all right, that's cool. And he lives in like a nice neighborhood. He pulls out like this 1950s like motor car, right? This like super, you know, it's his baby. He's got his hat tipped to the left, pulls up with his Adidas on, and he's like, get in. And I'm like, okay. So I get in this car with him, and he starts to go like 80 miles an hour through this neighborhood that he lives in. And he stops and he goes, you see that house right there? That's where Ferris Bueller's Day Off, where the Corvette goes out of the back of the garage. Yeah. That's that garage. And I'm like, what are you talking about? That's so weird. And all the neighbors are like, hey, Billy. Come on. Tell me that's not cool.
That's cool.
And then he stopped at Starbucks for me. And I was like, thanks, Billy.
I thought you were going to say you guys went to wrestling.
Well, he did. He did ask me to go to wrestling because he owns a lot of. He is a passionate wrestling fan. He doesn't just own a wrestling company. He is passionate about the history. He is passionate. He has the first ever belt for a female wore.
Wow.
Female wrestling wore back in, I think, like the 60s or something like that.
Wow.
And but then I got a chance to ask him, how'd you get that guitar tone on mayonnaise on the Siamese string? And he goes, do you really want to know, man? And I'm like, yeah. And I took out my notes and he's telling me how him and Butch Vig mic'd up these guitars. And oh my God, I was just in heaven, bro.
Amazing.
In heaven, he's the nicest guy to me.
That's awesome.
To me. I don't know how he treats other people.
You hear things,
but
that's
he's
awesome.
So sweet to me. And then he was doing this interview the other day with Allison Hagendorf from Spotify. Yeah. And he was like, yeah, man, me and that guy vibe. And I'm like, you just said I vibe with him? Oh my God, someone said they liked me? You know, it's kind of like, what?
That's
crazy.
That's a great story.
Yeah.
Tour going well. You're at Flynn Theater tonight, 8 o'clock.
It's going to be great.
Nice.
It's going to be awesome. What's that other place we used to play in town?
Higher Ground.
Yeah, is that still around?
Yeah, still around.
Yeah?
You guys have moved on up, though.
Is that moving up where we
yeah.
are now?
Yeah.
This is great.
Yeah.
I don't really take a look at, like, the numbers and all that stuff. I just run the label and put music out, and then they're like, your number, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, just keep on vibing.
Yeah, don't jinx it.
Keep on vibing, bro. But I do remember that there was this really cool cheese place right next to the Higher Ground.
The Cheese and Wine Traders.
Dude, I would go get cheese from there. Because I don't drink anymore. So I'd go in there and be like, there's a lot of cheese in here.
Yeah.
So good. But I'm sure you guys know that. You live here.
Yeah, maple syrup, you know.
I didn't try the maple syrup.
I was wondering. You're like, you pull into town. Yeah. You're on the bus. So let's you get off the bus. What do you got to do?
I got to go for a walk. Right. I have to go for a walk. I have to do at least 3 miles a day just walking.
Yeah.
And I'm listening to demos, so I'm writing always. And I've got to get a cold brew from somewhere. I've got to get a two-shot. This is how I am. I like to party. You know, I like to party hard. So I get 3 shots of espresso in a glass of ice. And then I get a cold brew, large. And just take
bang,
them both.
Bang, bang.
Within 5 minutes. And then I feel it hit me.
Yeah.
And then I sweat profusely, and I walk around and talk to strangers really fast.
I always wonder, if you're on that bus, you're like, I'm going to get off this bus, what am I doing first?
I like to get out and I like to walk around because there were so many years when I wasn't sober that I just stayed in hotel rooms and just was an idiot and didn't appreciate it. So now when I'm in beautiful places like this, I walk down to the lake and I sit there and I just take it and I smell the air. I was just telling Terry, my friend, and it smells so good here.
Fresh, clean air.
It's amazing. I live in Texas.
Yeah.
Let's just say that again.
Yeah.
I live in Texas.
All right.
You know, 117 degrees.
Thick. Weather. It's thick there.
It's thick, yeah. But it's beautiful here. I'll probably go out later. There's a flannel store. I kind of sound like Will Ferrell in that movie. Might go to Home Depot. No, I'm going to go check out a flannel store.
Vermont Flannel Company, good place.
I'm going there. I'm nice. Going to Vermont Flannel Company. I'm going to buy... I mean, can I just tell this really quick?
Yeah.
And I've only had 2 cups of coffee. And I'm talking like this. And I've been up for 5 hours. I went when my third child, Terry, was born, Gunner Black. I got to name him Gunner Black. But I remember I was here right after he was born, and I was like, I finally had a boy. And I went to Vermont Flannel Company, and I bought PJs with the little butt flap.
Yes.
Wow. He's the cutest little guy ever. I remember he wore those for the next 2 Christmases. Vermont Flannel, little butt flap PJs. I love you, Vermont Flannel. Love you. Be there today around like 3.
Well, the fantastic news is you brought your guitar.
Yes, sir.
We appreciate that. What do you feel like playing? What do you feel like playing?
I feel like, you know, today when I was on my walk, I saw some beautiful people. I saw beautiful people that were struggling. I saw beautiful people that... we're happy. I saw beautiful people that might just need a message of hope. So I was thinking maybe I could play a song about sobriety called Hate Me. Is that all right?
That's all right.
All right, cool. Here we go. I have to block out thoughts of you so I don't lose my head. They're crawling like a cockroach, leaving babies in my bed, dropping little reels of tape to remind me that I'm alone, playing movies in my head that make a porno feel. burning in my pride, a nervous bleeding in my brain. An ounce of peace is all I want for you, so don't call again. And never say that you love me, just to put it in my face. And never try to reach me, it is I on its face. Hate me today. Hate me tomorrow. Hate me so you can finally see what's good for you. And I'm sober now for 3 whole months. One accomplishment that you helped me with. But one thing that always tore us apart is the one thing I won't touch again. In my sick way, I want to thank you. Holding my head up late at night while I was busy waging wars on myself. You were trying to stop the fight. You never doubted my warped opinions on things like suicide or hate. You made me compliment myself when it was way too hard to take. Yes, yeah, so I'll drive so far away that it never crossed your mind. And do whatever it takes in your heart, just leave me behind. Hate me today. Hate me tomorrow. Hate me for all the things I didn't do for you. Hate me in ways. It weighs hard to swallow. Gotta hate me so you can finally see what's good for you. And with a sad heart I say bye to you and wave. Now I'm kicking these shadows on the street for every mistake that I made. Like a baby boy I never knew how to be a man. Until I saw your blue eyes cry and I held your face in my hand. And then I fell down yelling, make it go away. Could you please bring back a smile, make it shine like it used to be. And that's when she whispered, she said, how can you do this to me? Hate me today. Hate me tomorrow. Hate me for all the things I didn't do for you. Hate me away. Ways hard to swallow. Hate me so you can finally see what's good for you. Cause this is all for you. I swear from here on out, I swear to God, it's all for you. Yeah, this is all for you.
Plus studio, Justin from Booktober.
Cheer.
Amazing that, and you've been able to do this throughout your whole career, just the honesty and the unfiltered, like whether it's whatever you're feeling when you're writing the song, whether it's pain or struggle or happiness, how you're able to get that down on paper and get it into a song. That to me is a huge accomplishment.
I really appreciate that. There's a lot of insecurity that goes in with it, but it's just kind of like, I can't really watch myself perform or hear myself perform because I'm like, oh God, it's painful. Are you that way when you listen to yourself on the radio?
100%.
Oh my God, it's painful. I'm like, oh my gosh, I could lose that belly and my chin. Oh my gosh, it's just, oh. But then I'll sit back and like when I listen to like Chet Baker, like the old jazz guy,
yeah,
and he'd sing like, my funny valentine, and you don't want him to sing something happy. That's just what he does. He's that guy, right? And so I'm like, I'm that guy that just sings the sad truths. And I love that. So when I stay in that spot and get out of the hole looking at how much weight I need to lose, or what if I'm cool or not, well, I'm not Lovely the band, or I'm not, you know, this band. It doesn't matter. They're all friends of mine, but I'm proud of them, and this is my little thing that I do. And so I've always done it, you know, and I like it.
Yeah, congratulations.
Thanks, man. It's people like you that support me, because y'all could go, that guy's, you know, but to be surrounded by such cool, to be able to tour with, like, old, we used to tour with, like, Stone Temple Pilots, and, you know, and just be around some of these bands that are just incredible, like old Blind Melon, and growing up on, like, Nirvana and Radiohead and Coldplay, and you got all these cool new bands. It's great, but I've always thought, why aren't people writing more, honestly?
Like, right.
I guess they just
think it's hard.
They don't really want their personal stuff out there, and I don't care.
Right.
I'm a serial confessor, I guess. You can't really hold anything against me if I tell you my wrongs, you know what I'm saying?
you want to do another one?
Yeah. This one's good. This one's, I like this one a lot. I've been married twice, divorced twice, and I'm the happiest I've ever been. I have beautiful children with both of them. And I've had great friends. I've lost great friends. Life is crazy, ups and downs, right? But I wish nothing but glory and happiness for every single person out there that I've had any kind of contact with. And so I wrote this just kind of as a, it's a, I like it. There will be days when you're falling down, days when you're inside out. There will be days when you fall apart. Someone else will break your heart. They're never gonna hold you back. I'm always gonna have your back. So try to remember that. I hope you're happy. I hope you're good. I hope you get what you wish for. And you're well understood. Baby, I hope you're happy. if you're not mine.
Inside the bus studio, Justin from Blocktober.
The boss! Thank you!
Thank you so much.
Bro, thank you so much for having me here. This is what it's all about.
Well, the show tonight at the Flynn Theater. Veers is going to go on first at
Veers are cool, bro.
8 o'clock. Then you guys will come on sometime after that.
Yeah.
And I think if you hit the box office, there might be one or two tickets left for the show tonight. So
thank you.
Come see the show with us tonight, Blocktober. At
so
the Flynn Theater. Thank you for taking the time.
Can I get a picture with you before I leave?
100%.
Dude, much love. Thank you so much, guys.